Hey everyone, welcome to Ala1061. Today we will look at this beautiful new Range Rover Sport SVR. It has now 575 horsepower and 700 Nm of torque. It has of course the all-wheel drive system. It has a lot of new features in the interior. It has a Touch Pro Duo system, two 10-inch screens, one for the climate and car settings, one for the multimedia and navigation settings. It has the LCD screen for the instrument cluster. It has the new, more high-tech head-up display. It has also the new touch-sensitive buttons on the steering wheel, which I really like. This is the most powerful Range Rover Sport. It's a dream to drive and listen to it. Thanks for watching Ala1061. And this is how the key looks like, with the Land Rover badge, lock, unlock, headlights, and the trunk. It produces 575 horsepower and 700 Nm of torque. It has a 5-liter V8 petrol engine and the all-wheel drive system. 0 to 62 in 4.5 seconds, and the top speed is 280 km per hour. That's 175 miles per hour. It has an 8-speed automatic transmission. The fuel economy is 12.8 liters per 100 kilometers combined. When we take a closer look, you can see the beautiful, more aggressive SVR front bumper. It has also a special bonnet for the SVR. The grille is also new. You have the LED matrix headlights with the daytime running lights. The LED lights are new, and the shape of the daytime running lights are beautiful in my opinion. It has also the headlight washers, corner lights, and automatic I-beam. You can also buy it with the adaptive cruise control. The Range Rover badge is in black, and you have the SVR badge in the front bumper, of course. Big air intakes needed. And the black parts are finished in glossy black. Looks more beautiful in my opinion. It has 575 horsepower. It is lower, it has air suspension, it has the Terrain Response 2 system, and you can see the special bonnet for the SVR. Beautiful. It has 22-inch rims and red brake calipers. You can stiffen up the suspension in the dynamic mode. There's also an automatic mode, of course. You can still go
full off-road with this car. It's a full-size SUV. 22-inch rims. Comes with Continental tires. You have the side skirts, tinted rear windows. You can buy it with 360 degrees camera system, blind spot assist. We will take a look at the interior. It has also the ambient lighting and the new touch sensitive buttons on steering wheel. The seats are also special. 14-way adjustable. Two-tone color. And at the back you have the new taillights. Special shape with the dynamic turn signals. All LEDs for the taillights and the quad exhausts are also special for the SVR. This car sounds very, very good, especially for an SUV. It is for me the best sounding SUV, sports SUV. Quad exhaust, special diffuser, special rear bumper, of course. This is for me the most beautiful Range Rover Sport of all time. It has also an automatic trunk and the rear view camera. You can also buy it with the automatic parking system. All the chrome details are finished in glossy black, which gives it a mean look. And it has also a special spoiler for the SVR, as you can see. Beautiful. Can open the trunk with the key, and you can also close it with the key. It's an automatic trunk. Quad exhaust, of course. You can buy it with a tow hook. This is the space in the back. Pretty good. Underneath, even more space. You can raise and lower the back of the car. There's a power outlet, LED lights, of course. This is to cover your storage. And you can close it with this button or you can close it with the key. This is the driver's seat of the brand new Range Rover Sport SVR. Beautiful. There's the new touch sensitive buttons on the steering wheel. New F1 shift pedals, LCD screen with different displays, with the little SVR logo, of course. There's also the new head-up display with the traffic sign assist. SVR steering wheel with the perforation on the side. Very, very cool. There's a memory for the seats, for the mirrors, and for the steering wheel. Two screens for the first time, 10-inch, one for the off-road settings or the sport settings. You can choose between grass, mud, rocks. There's also a dynamic mode with the sports exhaust turned on.
Over here we have a leather armrest. Over here you have the HDMI USB inputs and a SD card input. You have a cool box with two settings over here. Over here you have cup holders, more storage area underneath. Electronic handbrake, of course. This is the off-road setting. It has the sport, it has the terrain response 2 setting. With this, the car knows on which surface you are driving and adjusts the suspension for that specific road. But you can also choose it by yourself with these buttons. It has also a eco mode, sports exhaust. It has the air suspension, you can raise and lower the car if you want. It has the gear lever lit up at night. You can also shift for yourself with the shift pedals behind the steering wheel, which are really cool, made out of aluminium. Feels very nice. You have the climate control settings. Dual 4 zone, also in the back, fan speed. The seats are available with heated, cooled and massage function. They are 14 way adjustable. Also in the rear, as you can see. It has also the cooled function, heated and cooled seats. Over here you have the climate control settings with the ionization, the vehicle settings and the normal display settings. You can also turn off the start-stop if you want. There's also a race mode. Over here you have the new tilting multimedia system. Dynamic setting. When you choose the dynamic setting, you can adjust the steering, suspension, gear, engine response. It has its own separate menu with the lap timer, the G meter, and the throttle and brake display. This is the factory setup. Can also choose a different setup if you want. This is the main menu. It has the ambient lighting with more colors now. You can turn it on or off if you want. These are the colors available for the ambient lighting. Brightness adjustment. And this display is also a LCD display, which looks really cool, and it has new touch sensitive buttons. Eco data on a SVR, not needed. Valet mode, 4x4 settings, the normal settings of the car. You can adjust the screen angle if you want. You have different themes, you can adjust the brightness, the navigation, phone settings, Bluetooth connectivity. It supports Apple CarPlay, Bluetooth connectivity, the camera. You can also buy it with the 360 degrees camera system.
over here you have a storage area, another storage area up here. SVR logo, of course. There's the Meridian sound system, memory for the passenger, three settings, beautiful SVR seats with the SVR logo. And over here you have the new
LCD screen. The top speed is 280 kilometers per hour. Different settings for the language, off-road settings, head-up display settings, car settings, media, active braking, lane departure, driving condition, driver condition monitoring, trip computer, and so on. These buttons are new. You have the lane assist on the steering wheel. You can also buy it with the heated steering wheel. There's a cruise control settings on it. All leather dash, all leather door panels. It has a new touchscreen buttons for the mirrors. This is also new. High quality materials are used. You have a storage area here. And the memory settings. Even this looks very expensive. Automatic lights, of course. Over here, dimming rear view mirror, SOS button, full Alcantara roof. And let's check out the rear seat. I really like the design of these cars, of these SUVs. Plenty of storage areas, adjustable reclining rear seats with also the SVR logo integrated in them. You have a little armrest, the space in the back is great. And this is the view from the back seat. There's the 4-zone climate control, beautiful new 2 screens. I really like the shape of the seats, sort of bucket seats. The space in the back is this. I'm 1.83 meters. You have the 4-zone climate control system. You can also buy it with heated seats, power inlets. Over here you have an armrest with 2 cup holders and a little storage area if you want. And these seats are special for the SVR. The shape, the design, the logos, and the SVR comes with the Alcantara headliner, no panoramic sunroof, as you can see.